everyone, and welcome to the launch of ServiceNow's Yokohama release. I'm Laura McManaman, Senior Developer Advocate, and I am thrilled to be speaking with you. For our 775,000 member community, there is something for everybody in Yokohama, whether you are a developer, a system admin, a platform owner, or anything in between. The best part of today's show is that we will be joined by some of our community experts who will be discussing their favorite features in this release. But more on that later. Here is the headline. All of this is live. You can do this now and get started today. We recently launched ServiceNow AI agents for every corner of your business. There are already thousands of pre-built AI agents that are out of box and available across IT, CRM, HR, and more. But what's really going to excite you is that you can build your own custom agents with AI Agent Studio. With all of these AI agents, you are also going to need a way for them to work together. That's where AI Agent Orchestrator comes in, ensuring teams of AI agents work together across tasks, systems, and departments. Okay, to kick us off, Amanda Jocelyn is here to take us through some of what you get with AI agents in Yokohama. Welcome, Amanda.
Thanks, Lauren. AI Agent Studio brings AI agents to every corner of your business, from front office to back office. You can use it out of the box to custom build your own AI agents using simple prompts to describe the work context of the agent you want to build and what you want it to do. Our AI agents learn from your data thanks to Workflow Data Fabric, our foundation that makes it easy for you to connect to and use any of your data. With these connections, AI agents reason, plan, and interact with one another to solve problems on your behalf. So who's ready for a demo? Let's start with this incident resolution AI agent and how you can customize it. The language prompts are general, meaning no code, allowing agents to reason freely without being confined by explicit steps, making them way more versatile. This out-of-the-box group of agents is great, but an admin wants to add a custom agent to help with their unique needs. By using natural language, she builds an AI agent that references network data, making the diagnostic capabilities much stronger and more accurately detecting application error incidents. With our external connectors, you're able to access any data fast, like Microsoft SharePoint and cloud storage APIs, so you can build and integrate with all of your enterprise data, no matter where it lives. You see here that an existing flow action is used to trigger a diagnostic agent to pinpoint network issues. Guardrails in place ensure AI agents only act on your behalf, and you decide when actions are taken with human supervision or executed autonomously. But what powers all of this under the hood? Workflow Data Fabric. Here, we see Workflow Data Fabric connecting both structured and unstructured data through our zero-copy connectors with Snowflake, Databricks, Google Cloud, Oracle, and searchable data in Microsoft SharePoint. Zero-copy means your data stays where it resides without having to copy it into ServiceNow. This eliminates unnecessary duplication of data and promotes data cleanliness. Take a bank, for example. With a few clicks, they created a zero-copy data connection, bridging terabytes of real-time application, credit, and risk data without moving any of it directly into ServiceNow. The real-time field and record mapping takes all that data and harmonizes it into a single model, just like we're used to. The data is kept in its original systems, but you can treat it like any other data source in the ServiceNow platform. What does this look like for our customers and support agents? We're now seeing the human agents workspace at that bank we just mentioned. And with Stream Connect, they even have network monitoring systems tied to ServiceNow, which helps to identify a spike in error logs. An AI agent proactively identifies that this outage would impact the ability to open new customer accounts at thousands of locations. Trying to diagnose this manually would have taken hours and potential downtime for the bank. But with AI agents, we see all the steps that have already been taken. The bank's incident resolution agent flagged the issue, and this triggered the diagnostic agent to analyze all the systems involved with opening these accounts. By leveraging these connected data sources, the problem was instantly identified as a recent software update, which caused the outage. Because this bank has all their data connected, the AI agents leverage SharePoint, network data, and existing knowledge base articles to create this end-to-end resolution plan. Management approves the suggested resolution, and the team of AI agents orchestrates a series of tasks to restore system access to 8,000 branches. The AI agent sends the email to all impacted parties, prompting them to log back in to restore access. Problem solved. That's how you custom build AI agents. CJ Wesley is here. Welcome, CJ. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you for having me, Amanda.
Of course. So you've been in the community for 12 years and a four-time MVP. That's awesome.
Pretty awesome, right?
Yeah, you've seen a lot of innovation during that time. How do you see AI agents really shaping the future of your work?
For me, it's all about the people. And I see AI agents making it a lot easier for folks to get better service quicker and more consistently. And I also see it freeing up a lot of time for the creators so they can build more tools, more applications for the business, and deliver more value.
You've done a lot of implementations in your time, CJ. Where do you suggest customers get started with their implementations?
So I would start with Now Assist. Right, AI agents are built on Now Assist, so I think that's the logical starting place. From there, I look at incident response agents. I think that enables the service desk to provide a better level of service to folks in an automated fashion, but also allow the agents to escalate those incidents that need to be escalated to a person a lot quicker. You know, from there, there's also the Okta agent that I like as well. There's a lot of folks who always forget their password, right? And so the Okta agent allows us to validate that identity a lot easier, right? And it keeps our system secure, which is important in this day and age.
Absolutely. So my team's put a lot of enablement out there. Where do you get started learning about AI agents, and how do you recommend everyone else get started as well?
Sure. Docs is always the first place that I go. I go back to the wiki days, and so the wiki's no longer here with us, but the docs is the spiritual successor, right? So that's where I always start. But then from there is the community. There's so much talent out there and so many people willing to share, right? And if you go to both of those places and you can't find what you need, then I try the academies, right? I take a couple of academies and see if that will help. And then finally, just reach out to an MVP, right? Like, we're out here, we're willing to help, and we're always, always, always willing to embrace the community.
I love that. The MVPs are such a great asset to us. And speaking of which, hopefully I'm going to see you at Knowledge this year. Are you going to be at any of our sessions?
Absolutely. I haven't missed the Knowledge since I joined the community.
Thank you so much for being here, CJ.
Thanks for having me, Amanda. I really appreciate it.
Of course. Lauren, back to you.
Okay. After that demo, we know you want to start creating AI agents right away, but there's more. Here's Tom Freeman to unpack workflow and automation updates. Tom?
Thanks, Lauren. ServiceNow Studio is the new unified experience for all development on the ServiceNow platform. With built-in help from Now Assist, powered by GenAI, it helps you build faster with easy-to-use tools. So application development is more intuitive, more collaborative, and for people using the platform every day, like you and me, more fun. Let's get started with ServiceNow Studio. Andrew, a developer, needs to create a new app to track volunteer programs and employee volunteer hours at his company. So he opens ServiceNow Studio. Using the inline conversational interface, Andrew uses app generation to build a working application using natural language prompts. He can add a new table, new roles and permissions, and even create a record producer. At the preview stage, Andrew can review the details and make changes before saving and moving on. And just like that, Andrew has a new app to work with. App file navigation allows for editing files across any application scope at the same time, including out of the box. This makes it easy for him to find what he wants to work on next. For example, Andrew can navigate to the new app, then drill down to take a look at the table. He can make modifications to the new app table as needed. Everything looks good here, but he thinks he might want to add a new custom field to the location table to specify if a certain location is related to a volunteer event. Without changing context or scopes, he can easily open the reference table in a new tab. Let's say he wanted to cross-reference another app. Without leaving ServiceNow Studio, Andrew can simply go back to the file navigator and navigate to the app, which is in another scope. It's then opened in a new color-coded tab. And as you can see down at the bottom left here, the current working scope has changed. It's pretty cool, right? Let's get back to the new app we just created. App summarization empowers developers to easily add AI-generated descriptions to their applications right in ServiceNow Studio. What you're seeing is Now Assist reviewing the structure of the underlying data models to understand the purpose of the app and provide a succinct description. Gaining quick understanding of the function of a new application helps approvers understand its purpose during the review and approval phase. App summarization will save you time to focus on the more creative problem solving that requires a human touch. Next up, RPA bot generation. RPA automates repetitive, manual tasks with or without human input, especially the tasks that do not have APIs that allow traditional integrations. RPA reduces the chance of human error when repetitively performing a task. We all know invoice automation workflows are a time-consuming task for a human. It's a great option for automation. From RPA Desktop Design Studio, we'll begin the process by selecting the Now Assist option. We then simply add in the automation requirement into the input prompt. We've provided our use case as input to the LLM, and what we'll create is a way to receive invoices from multiple vendors sent via email, save them to a folder, then process each invoice to extract the text. Prior to bot generation, RPA devs and automation teams had to manually design the bot-based automations or make use of existing templates provided for common use cases. With RPA bot gen, we're able to design a specific bot using natural language, dramatically speeding up the bot development process. With the regenerate preview button, we can add to or modify the automation until we have exactly what we want. We have the option to then create the automation as attended or unattended. In this case, we'll choose unattended and give it a name and a description if we want, and then save. Now the automation preview is saved in the main activity of the invoice management project. Here you can see the different automation steps that were created by Now Assist. At this point, dev teams can proceed to check and modify the generated bot as required, following the same manual development process that they're already used to. Or they can use inline prompting to generate an object using natural language, just like we saw for RPA generation and app generation at the beginning of this demo. That's how RPA teams will create bots to automate repetitive, manual tasks, and how ServiceNow Studio will help you build faster with easy-to-use tools. I'm happy to welcome Carleen Carter, Principal Architect with Serenity, to talk about everything you've just seen. Welcome, Carleen.
Thank you so much for having me.
Now, I know you're passionate about ServiceNow, sharing your knowledge with others, and helping the community. So I am curious, how do you feel ServiceNow Studio will impact your day-to-day life on the platform?
ServiceNow Studio has already made me more efficient as I'm working through script includes and business rules and access controls. They're all now in one place. I can open multiple and across the tabs instead of having a bunch of browser tabs. And I do not have to change scopes anymore.
Love that. Big time. Are you rediscovering any hidden gems in the platform or anything that kind of popping up within the tool?
Yeah, I've been finding some different records that I didn't realize, mostly part of the UI builder experience and all of the different components of that. And it's really expanded my view of what is going on and created a lot of learning experiences. I think it's going to be really great for people that are new to the ServiceNow ecosystem as well, because they'll have everything right there. Whereas maybe before you had to hunt and peck and try to figure out where to do things.
Yeah. So I'm kind of curious. You're a bit ahead of the curve here, already taking advantage of ServiceNow Studio. How do you think other organizations can take advantage of ServiceNow Studio today?
Well, the first thing that they need to do is install it. And they have to be on Xanadu patch 3 at least. But
least or Yokohama.
Right. I'm excited that it'll be installed on all of my customer instances as soon as they get to Yokohama. So get to Yokohama.
That's right. Yeah. As of Yokohama, we are now going to be automatically installing ServiceNow Studio. So it's going to be an out-of-the-box component you can take advantage of on your day-to-day basis.
The other thing that I did when I first started using ServiceNow Studio was use some of the apps that I already had. So I wasn't just starting with a blank canvas, then I looking at some white screen and I didn't know what to do. I was looking at the apps that I already had and exploring them in a new way. I have tasks that I have to do on a regular basis, development tasks, and instead of just doing the same way that my muscle memory has attuned me to for years, I went and tried to do that in ServiceNow Studio. And it's definitely different, but change is not bad. And I definitely want to be one of those folks that embraces the change of ServiceNow Platform, because I'm so excited about all of the new things that you're going to incorporate into ServiceNow Studio as well.
Yes, indeed. Thank you so much for being here today, Carlene, and for representing the ServiceNow community.
Thank you so much for having me.
You betcha. And with that, Lauren, back to you.
Thanks, Tom. Thanks, Amanda. And thank you again to our MVPs, CJ and Carlene. I am so excited about all the AI innovation in ServiceNow Studio, the AI agents, and we look forward to seeing how you leverage them. We covered a lot of ground, and this is just a fraction of the new features coming your way with the Yokohama release. And the best part of this is not a teaser. Everything we showed you is live today, so go out there and use it. We are on the road to Knowledge 2025, and to everyone out there watching today, I want you, yes, you, to head to our Knowledge site and register today. Be sure to sign up for that creator contract, too. This is tailor-made for people like you who build on our platform. Thank you, and I'll see y'all at Knowledge.